I'm Jack Rickard with EVTV. This is my compadre and consigliere, Brian L. Noto.
How are you doing?
We call him the brain. Been some questions about that. See Steven Spielberg, Pinky and the Brain. If you haven't watched them, you don't know what cartoons really are about.
That's right. I've got the little miniature characters.
We're going to do something a little bit different today that I think is, I'm pretty excited about it. Brain has had an idea on how to take over the world.
And that is our mission, taking over the world.
And I know you think it's something else. We've been, this next month, a year and a half, doing videos about electric vehicle conversions. And a year since Brain come up with the idea that we really had to do the show weekly. So in a past life, we're actually publishers. We don't really make cars.
No.
Actually, our cars are pretty good. We ought to be car makers, but
it's a lot of work.
I like driving. But we're not car makers, we're publishers. And Brain is actually one of the best closers in the business. He worked for a number of magazines before me, but at Boardwatch, when he slid the pen, it was over. And when we sold that, we had 24 annual contracts, unheard of in the computer business that went with. So I was asking him this last week, so how come we don't have any revenue?
We got no money, man.
We got no money. Actually, it's a little more organized than that. In order to, a lot of people want to get sponsorship, support, and so forth when they don't really have anything to sell. We spent a year and a half building a viewership, and actually we distributed it on Amazon's CloudNet. It cost me about 20 cents, 25 cents, depending on the length of the video. Every time one of you watch one of these videos or download it, in bandwidth charges. This is the dirty little secret behind YouTube's ongoing losses is that video takes a lot of bandwidth. And but I can monitor those expenses and tell pretty much that we've got a pretty good viewership now. We've got some people that watch every week and download these videos pretty hard. Because the bill's getting to be pretty big.
The bill's starting to grow, yeah, it's big.
But the concept is you have to build a viewership first, and then you have something to sell.
Right.
And we think we're pretty much getting there. I think we've got a pretty good penetration in almost everyone doing electric vehicle conversions at this point. And so we need to monetize that a little bit. And so I started to beat Brian up about how we were going to kick off this concept of advertising. He sent out some coffee cups and talked to some people. And had a lot of great conversations, but we haven't really got this off the ground. And so I asked him what we were going to do about that, and here's what he came up with.
Well, our thought is to just completely drop our pants around our ankles, show you how much we love you, and give you what, $20,000 worth of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
Well, his idea is to give you $20,000 worth of my stuff.
Oh, all right.
I had a little different take on that.
All right.
But what we've come up with. We do hear from a lot of people that are very interested in doing a conversion, but can't because it's expensive.
It's expensive.
Well, I think cars are expensive. Actually, I was at Schnucks the other day and bought an onion for $2.35. So I think cars and onions are expensive.
That's an awfully nice onion.
It was a really ordinary looking onion. Have you people been checking what's going on? They're not talking about this on TV, but it was $2.35 for an onion. Anyway, cars are expensive anyway, and gasoline certainly is. I drive these cars, and it it feels like it costs nothing to drive them because I'm plugging them into the wall.
Right.
They bill me monthly. But truly, it's a couple of bucks to charge the car.
Right. It's not much.
And, I mean, I changed some light bulbs and made the bill go back down.
Yeah, exactly.
You can almost offset your driving with light bulbs. So I don't think it's expensive. But the initial, there's kind of a leap of faith there that mm-hmm. you can complete the project once you've spent typically $15,000 on parts.
Yeah.
We've kind of surveyed our local EV group, what percentage of them are using lithium ion batteries, and the results were discouraging.
Yes, not that many. A lot of lead acid guys out there.
The president's got an order in, and one other guy had an order in to EV components and got beat out of $16,000,
which was a bad deal.
Sort of a setback.
Yeah.
So here's the concept. We want one of you to build your dream EV. And we're going to put together a pile of stuff to let you do it. I can't do it for everybody. But
no, only one.
We're going to announce a contest where you fill out a very egregiously long and stupid survey form.
What did they expect from us, though? Two-hour videos.
Right.
A few questions, guys. Get over it.
Because Brian needs to know who you are and why you watch this thing in order to tell the tale.
We got to tell some people about
this. I think this is, by the way, just to transgress, this is the future of video, is internet distribution. And it will be commercially monetized.
Mm-hmm.
But instead of having a separate group with the cable or the broadcast network selling ads and a different group buying the programming, you wind up with this horrifying situation where I'm watching House and suddenly there's an OxyClean commercial, usually seven or eight of them. And it breaks it up in my mind. Now, we did this with Boardwatch Magazine. We had a magazine and half of it was ads. But they were all ads about the stuff our readers wanted to know about.
Right. No Franklin Mint ads for the little figurines or plates or.
Right. No, it was all about an internet apparatchik that you needed to play,
right.
Be a player. And so it was very well received. And I think that in the future internet video, the ones that win will be the ones with what I would call context-sensitive advertising. And that's commercials about stuff that has something to do with what the show's about.
Right, what the viewers are interested in.
And so we're not going to have ads for OxyClean or Dove detergent. I watched Jay Leno's garage show the other day. He had Dove soap was the sponsor.
Oh, on his internet show, yeah.
What am I missing a trick here? You know, why am I watching a Dove commercial? So this is a little bit ahead of the game, and so we kind of have to train our advertisers, our viewers, and everybody else to what we're doing and why that would make sense for everybody involved. This contest, we have one sponsor at the moment, and that's George Hamster with NetGain, and he has contributed a NetGain a Wart 9 motor.
And this is it.
And a little contribution toward my expense, we're going to contribute 50 China Aviation Lithium Battery Company 180 amp hour cells. That's 167.5 volts nominal, about a 30 kilowatt pack, and that'll get you down the road quite a bit.
Yeah, that's a nice pack.
I'd like to announce the death of lead acid, guys. It's, I know you've had fun with it, but it's a lot more fun when the car is just something you drive. Our cars are pretty much down to get in, turn a key, and drive them away. And in actual use, I'm not monitoring the state of charge. I'm not monitoring how many miles I've been.
No, not anymore.
I really just drive the car.
Just drive the car, yeah.
and plug it in a couple times a week or more if I'm doing a lot of driving. But and these batteries are the concept. The Cal batteries, that's true, I've got a little bit of a bias for them anyway. They have a very flat discharge curve, and they behave very well.
Yes.
And when I get them, they're pretty consistent from one cell to the next.
Yeah, they've been very nice.
I have come into some information that may be a little bit biased. It's a little bit confidential. Internal to Cal, but it has to do with low temperature operations. And we've never really tested this. I'm probably going to do some testing of that. They did some minus 25s. The way this started was their spec sheet had list charging at 0 degrees right. C as the minimum.
Right.
I've got a problem with that. When I contacted them, they said, no, it won't hurt the batteries, but it won't be as efficient. Well, how efficient do I need to be charging?
Right.
I just don't want to hurt the cells at 0 degrees
Fahrenheit,
which sometimes it does get here. But they sent me some data about minus 25 degrees C discharge patterns for both the Calbs and the Thunder Skies. Thunder Skies were coming in at about 60% capacity, and the Calbs were about 85%.
That's a big difference.
And it's kind of put me in mind to heat our battery boxes in the Escalade.
All right.
We may try to work out some sort of a heating situation. I have noticed in the lab that as the batteries heat, I get a little... This little hump in the front of all the tests is when the batteries warm up, they do better. They put out more voltage,
more
current. And so I think we've been looking at heat as the problem, and with most of our components it is. With the batteries, it may be the opposite. Maybe that's where we need to move the heat. And that's kind of a innovative concept. Anyway, I'm going to spring... for about $10,000 worth of Calb cells, and that's what we've selected, is the 180 amp hour cell. I think
right
this is as good as it gets right now, and they're pretty much bulletproof batteries.
Yeah,
we use them with
hard.
No BMS. We charge them, we undercharge them a little bit. We try not to over-discharge them, and that works out pretty well. We did talk to several battery guys about a sponsorship. They wanted a lot of strings attached. And so I think I'm going to buy the batteries, and we're going to solicit a little contribution from each of our sponsors. Our first sponsor is NetGain, George Hanna with Warp 9.
Yeah.
And we mentioned that they had a new version of the Warp 9 motor with 26 improvements, and this week we received our contest motor from George, and we're pretty tickled with it. It has some obvious and not so obvious improvements. The first you'll notice is half-inch terminals, much heavier terminals. It does have this snap switch connection here for temperature.
Yes, I think 120C that kicks in.
180.
180C, okay.
Yeah, it may be 120 is when
the
alert.
Yep.
This motor is rated up to 180 degrees centigrade, class H insulation. Mm-hmm. That's why they're pretty hardy. But one of the reasons I'm excited about this upgrade, and we actually also bought one for another project, we're gonna upgrade Speedster Part Uno.
OG Speedster.
And we're going to add a few batteries, change around our batteries a little bit, and put this new Warp 9 in that. We bought one, and he contributed one for the contest. And in exchange, he's going to get a one-minute commercial for each of the episodes
during the
contest.
Yep.
Contest is going to run 6 months. and he'll get a 1 minute commercial for his motor for each episode during that. Mm-hmm. And and then we're going to have a 5 minute segment reminding you how to enter the contest in each episode, and it'll again be featured. But this new motor has a significantly improved casting on the fan to move mm-hmm. more air through the motor. It's got some, he calls them hella high carbon brushes with heavier springs that reduces arcing and wear on the commutator, mm-hmm. believe it or not. You would think with heavier springs that would increase the wear. It actually decreases it. And so these motors, which had previously been restricted to 160 volts, now he winces when he says it, but he's pretty sure.
Really, when he was on camera, he didn't really want to say it.
That they'll really do 192 volts now without arcing and flashing. So that's a pretty good improvement. With this pack at 167 volts and a controller that would do 1,000 amps, you basically have 167 kilowatt system.
That's nice.
Or something over 200 horsepower. You could do a pretty nice little sports car with this, and it would go.
Very nice.
As to the rest of the package, we're not there yet. We're still shopping, and we kind of picked them. They have to agree to it, of course.
Right.
But we're going to have some more components in the pile, a controller, and we're looking at several, including the Soliton, the Net Gain controller, and a couple of others. I have a couple of Zillas on the shelf. If they don't want to play ball, it's not a problem. Here's the problem with the Zilla. Yeah. The rest of our viewers can't really go buy one. I've talked to Otmar. I can't tell if they're for sale, not for sale. He had that bad experience with EV components. He says he has some, but he didn't.
It's just hard to tell.
I can't make it out, but it's very difficult for me to talk about a controller that you can't buy anyway. But we may use that for this contest. I've got two of them on the shelf. But we're talking to some other people about that. Several about a charger. So I want the contest to include the basics: a battery system, a motor, a controller, and a charger. And we may pick up some bit pieces as sponsors along the way. Aside from that, a DC to DC converter or something. Hell, I might make them one out of I-Core bricks.
We're talking to a lot of different people. So the basic prize package, the batteries, the motor, the controller, the charger, that you're in with that. Then anything else, it's just a added bonus.
We're going to put a survey questionnaire up on the website. And we want you to describe a little bit about yourself and then a little bit about what you would use all these components for to build.
Yes.
And it's not really a random drawing. This is kind of more of America's Got Talent type thing. We're going to go through and pick out probably 10.
Yep, I think 10 would be good.
10 would be good.
Yeah.
And the last month of the contest, we're going to ask those 10 people to send some photos, photos of their proposed donor car, mm-hmm. And a little bit more detail about what they want to build with it.
Right.
And we're going to put that up on the web for you all to vote on.
Exactly.
And we're going to let our viewers determine who gets the final pile. I expect it to be about $20,000 worth of components, so you could do a deluxe build.
You're doing a nice vehicle.
I'm thinking of this as a dream build, and it won't include all the terminals and bit pieces and so forth. I'm going to pay for the shipping.
Okay.
So it's going to arrive on their doorstep, wherever that is in the world.
Yeah, well, 40% of our viewers are not in the United States.
That's true enough.
Yeah.
So I could take a pretty big hit on the shipping.
The shipping is a lot of stuff to ship.
Oh, well. And we're going to try to pick up a few more sponsors with this along the way and try to build this into the ultimate build. The concept then is at the end of 6 months, somebody gets the pile of stuff, but then we want to follow the build with our episodes.
Yes.
And so our sponsors will get, again, some exposure along the way to the final completed car. But they'll be a little bit invested in its success.
Yes, a little bit invested.
They're not going to want somebody to make a car that doesn't work.
Right. Yep. Yeah, you might get a little
So help. I think you'll get pretty
I
good
think you'll
tech
get some
support.
Yeah, exactly.
From the guys that contribute the stuff, because they're going to want you to do a bang up car and make them look good.
Exactly.
Basically. And so I believe this will be an absolute win for our viewers.
I believe so.
An absolute win for our sponsors. They're going to get 6 months and conceivably another 6 months
more, yes.
Of basically free advertising for the contribution toward the batteries and the
hardware. Yep.
And it's going to get us a little bit better fixed to physically and logistically deal with ad rolls and that sort of thing. For us, I think it's going to cause a bump in viewership, Brian. I think your idea is fantastic.
Well, thanks, Jim.
Because what I'm about is the viewer end, and I think it's going to cause a lot of interest.
I think so, too.
I think a lot of people are going to want to enter this contest. What else does it do? It tells us a little bit about who they are.
Yeah, you guys are out there watching the shows, and you know, some of you, a lot of you email to Jack. I see some of the emails of guys come down to the shop. Mm-hmm. You know, we're right here, they see by the river. But there's a lot of you out there doing some very interesting things. You know, Matthew, who you met last week, was one of our viewers. Now he's out here helping us with the Escalade project. So there's some stuff out there. There's some people that have some
We're
have
not
some knowledge.
Entirely in the dark, but they know a little bit more about me than I do quite about
exactly.
them.
Exactly. We need to know a little bit about you.
And so this is going to be a very intrusive questionnaire. We want to know who you're sleeping with, why you picked her, why you put up with all that crap.
Yeah.
No, we don't want to know
that. We don't know
that
about
stuff.
That. Yeah, no jelly cam coming up. No, it's okay.
No, we don't want to know that. But other than that, we do want to know who our viewers are and kind of get a sense a better sense for how many of them there are and what they're looking for, and that'll help us improve the show.
Absolutely.
So we're going to win. I think our sponsors are going to win, and I think our viewers are going to win, and one of them is going to win pretty big.
Going to be a pretty big deal, yeah. I think so.
So that's the contest. What have I forgotten to cover about it?
Well, I guess they can come in. The form is going to be up with this show.
Yeah,
we're going to be able to take you live, a link from the homepage. Really one time entering the contest.
Mm-hmm.
We'll pretty much take care of it. The odds really won't increase. It's it's like the lottery, right?
Right.
Buying $5 for the lottery tickets does not increase your odds.
Yeah, multiple entries, it's going to give us more to look through.
More to paw through.
But that's about it. But yeah, give us a good description of what you would build, and that's kind of what we're looking for. And ultimately, you, the viewers, are going to decide who gets the pile.
Right.
I'm not going to pick one. And so that's pretty much how it's a little, not quite an X Prize.
No, but they haven't given anything away either.
Yeah. No, actually, they did.
Did they pick a winner?
Yeah, they've got three. One is Edison. Two, it's an alcohol-powered car.
We like alcohol.
I do, but I don't want to give it to my car.
That's right. There's only a five. It's like helium. There's a helium shortage.
He won $5 million. They had an electric that won the sort of side by side, and then a separate tandem, one in back of the other electric.
Okay.
That each won $2.5 million, But it was kind of a limp close. A lot of the cars didn't make it to there.
Didn't make the cut,
Our two favorites.
we told you about them.
The Future Vehicle Technologies and Illuminati.
Illuminati up in Illinois.
Illuminati's threatening to bring their car down and show it to us. And,
oh, really?
Yeah, drive it down.
All right, come on down.
Got it going pretty good. So we may have a segment with Illuminati. I still think they're winners.
Me too. They're winners in my book.
And so that's what happened with the XPRIZE. This is going to be a little bit different. But we're going to put together a package with a motor, a controller, and a charger, and a battery pack. And that's the big four. Mm-hmm. And we may add a few other bit pieces as we go along the way. We're looking pretty hard at a couple people for a controller. And one very interesting one for a charger. I think if we bring that together, that's going to be a very interesting rollout.
Yep.
I should have my first version of it this week, and we want to take a look at the charger and so forth. But if it does what I think, we may have a very interesting charger for them.
Good.
For the contest.
Looks good. Interesting to see it.
So that's what we're going to do. Our first contributor is George Hamstra and NetGain. That's kind of poetic. Our first conversion was with a NetGain 9.
NetGain 9.
Our latest was going to be with NetGain 9s. I've chickened out. We're going to do 211s now.
Get out the yardstick.
George kind of squeezed me on that, said that he'd be more comfortable if we used a couple of 11s just to make sure this thing takes
this
off.
This thing moves around.
Overkill's always appropriate, so I think the 2.9s would work with our transmission.
We have some gearing. Yeah.
But then 2.11s would work better, wouldn't they?
Yeah, just in case. That's right. Yeah, I only want to do it once.
So we're going to do that. I'm excited about his new motor. The improved airflow is the big
thing
for me.
That's a big deal. Yeah.
Bigger terminals is interesting. I think that's a good thing. We've got a snap switch here for the temperature.
And we've got a thermistor over on this side that they can't see. We've got to plug in for that.
We've got mounting holes now in four places around the motor. I think that was an improvement. The bigger brushes is huge with the bigger brush springs. That's a big deal, so I think it's all around a better motor. We're going to go back and revisit Speedster Part 1 update that, probably with these kind of batteries.
Yep.
And the new Warp 9 and upgrade our controller. And add a few batteries. I think I've got a way to get some underneath.
I think we can get some in there.
And get the voltage up a little bit, get a little higher power out of that, and do kind of a turbo speedster.
Yeah, and change the gearing. We already know about that.
We've got a new transaxle coming to match what we did, and that worked out so well.
That worked out great.
And so we're still looking at a lot of projects, but NetGain continues to be the staple around here. We've played with some AC motors. They're interesting. I like them. I like all these toys. Mm-hmm. Is the problem. But for a basic build or a new build, this would be the motor I would recommend people start out
with.
It's
what we used. Yeah.
And it's just about bulletproof, and you're going to get a good rolling car. Using that motor. And so that's where we've gone to and have gotten support from on the motor. We actually picked them. I think this is the one to have for the contest. And we picked the batteries, and we're kind of picking the other
ones. We're picking the rest of you. Some of you just don't know yet.
It's
I'll be calling.
But hopefully we'll use this to demonstrate how the ads would work.
Right.
Certainly these sponsors are going to find out how effective they are. And when you have context-sensitive advertising. And by this time next year, I think we'll be rolling pretty well as a publication.
Yep.
And
well, and we are now. We're our viewership is pretty big.
Well, we've got the viewership.
We've got a nice viewership.
But by this time next year, Brain, you're supposed to have us some revenue.
All right.
I've done my part.
All right. All right.
I got my part going pretty good, baby. We've got a viewership.
Yeah, we do.
Some of us need to bring up the other end. No, that's kind of the horse before the cart is where it belongs. That's how you do this in publishing, and we've done it before. So there wasn't any confusion
here.
Here
we go.
Here.
That's right.
So that's how we're going to do it. And so the best I can tell you is get on the website and get your entry in and get in the game. Mm-hmm. We'll run it about 6 months.
Six months would be good.
And ship a deluxe dream build pile of components to one of our viewers, wherever that might be. So stay with us. I'm Jack Rickard for EVTV.
I'm Brian Miller.